All right. Some global GMP thoughts for you. I've thrown out a lot of references. Those are the websites you can get it. They're all in English and they're all free, except for Japan, where the official publication is in Japanese. If you want the English version, the official translator and publisher is Yakuji Nippo Company. That's their website, and they will charge you about $100 for every document you want. And they will deliver within 3 days. I don't know how they do that, but they do. Key international GMP documents, if you want to follow and see where things are moving, this is my personal list. If you're interested in computer systems and computer software validation, the Center for Devices and Radiological Health is the leader in FDA of everything to do with validation of computer systems. Your IT group should look at that. There are at least 20 guidelines that are appropriate. If you have computer systems, that's the place to go. Canada, risk categorization if you're an auditor, validation guidelines on everything from cleaning, blow, fill, seal, tableting, you name it. Easy to read, logical, easy to understand, and if you implement it, FDA will have no problem whatever you do. Europe, chapter one of the European GMPs on quality gives you 13 things you have to look at in your annual product quality review. FDA has never actually spelled out what you have to look at in APQRs. In America, it's PQR, product quality review. In Europe, it's the annual product review. I just merged the term together to give you APQR. Read those 13, incorporate it into your American system, both for drugs and for APIs, you'll be fine. The role of the QP, that's the person in Europe who can release the drug. That's basically the totality of what QA has to do here. Read that and you'll have a detailed definition of the role of QA. And lastly, we don't have GMPs for clinical trial manufacturing. Europe does. It's not quite a discount on general GMPs. There are some extra stuff. Read that if you're into clinical trial manufacture. WHO, I mentioned these two guidelines. The other incredible one is method transfer guidelines. How do you know that you've transferred an analytical method properly between two labs for between AMD and QC? How do you know you've transferred properly between two different companies? Follow those guidelines. They give you numerical. You demonstrate you can do this, it's transferred properly. That's a great guideline to follow. And I mentioned different PICS guidelines, a great one on how to do validation master planning, IQ, OQ, PQ, and cleaning. These are good things to read. GMPs worldwide, please be aware, in most countries, they are codes, directives, guidelines, and industry practices. They're not compulsory. In America, Japan, and Korea, there are regulations which you must follow to the word, to the letter. So you can argue and discuss with all these people. With America, Japan, and Korea, you can't. So just be aware of that. Now, why do the regulators stress all this concept of quality management? Several reasons, and it affects agencies worldwide. Number one, all the regulators worldwide have severely limited budgets and manpower, especially in these times of economic recession. Greece, the inspection agency in Greece, shrank from 19 people down to 4. Purely because the government doesn't have money. And one of the groups they wiped out was the group tackling counterfeit drugs. Greece is now awash in counterfeit drugs. Manpower, inspectorates are aging. FDA has officially 1,300 official GMP inspector positions. There's only about 900 filled right now. The rest are empty. Nobody wants to work to FDA because the salary is so terrible. And of those 900, about one third could retire tomorrow morning on full salary because they've put in their 25 years. And many of them are leaving. They're pulled by industry in the bigger salaries. So recently, one head of one FDA inspection group left FDA, joined industry at 5 times the salary. She now makes $400,000. When they go, they take with them all their institutional knowledge. FDA is not the agency it used to be. It really isn't. They've lost the people who knew what to look for and what to ask for. If you were head of an inspection agency, you'd want all of your inspectors not to be, some have super duper tough inspectors and some really not knowledgeable. You want them all to be really tightly defined on whatever standard you're going for. Whether that standard is being a tough standard like the British, like the FDA would like to be, or a loose standard like the Ghanaians. You just want to have everybody at the same standard. Today, unfortunately, the FDA looks like that. And this is not from me, this is FDA people speaking. They've lost the institutional knowledge. There are still a few extremely good inspectors, but most of them not there. To counter this, FDA set up a group called the International Pharmaceutical Inspection Cadre, only concentrating on drugs. They have to go to a special 36-week course on drug manufacture. Well, that was the program, and then budget cuts that wiped out that program. FDA's got real troubles today. FDA used to send two inspectors always overseas. This year, I've had four of my clients with a single Rome inspector. Last week, I had a client in Canada with an inspector, and that inspector inspecting a API facility had never been in one before in his life. So why are you here, they asked. And they said, well, I'm a food inspector, and I happen to be in this area. So they said, add on 3 days and do you two. It's not good. As a consultant, I come across my clients as a hero. As a citizen, I say, this is terrible. So your budgets at work and whatever the discussions are in Washington this week, I can see FDA shutting down with everybody else next week. The industry is global. Different countries make different stages of production. I have one client who makes the API in China, does the granulation in Singapore, does the tableting in Brazil, does the spray coating in Puerto Rico, and does the packaging in Ireland, all to take advantage of cheap labor, taxes, that's Singapore and Brazil, the ability to label it made in the USA, that's why we do the spray coating in Puerto Rico, the ability to label it made in Europe, that's why the packaging is in Europe, so depending where he goes, he labels it different ways. It's all taxes, profits, and money. That gives the authorities a problem. When Upjohn used to exist, you remember Upjohn? Became Pharmacia, became Pfizer, became nothing. Kalamazoo was Upjohn, right? They would develop things like minoxidil. Same building, same site, rather. API manufacture, development, every step of it, including the distribution system, was in Kalamazoo. FDA could go there for a week and done. Now it's five separate trips around the world. Their budget can't stand it. That was the push, by the way, for them to join PICS. And there's different standards in different parts of the world. And lastly, they don't want to be your QA group. They realize they are coming for 5 days, and they can literally in 5 days only look at 5 to 10% of what's going on. And the things they come up with are the things that were so bad, they hit them in the face. And they say, look, we're just highlighting, which is why FDA moved its strategy of how they respond to your response to a 483 from if you had a 483 that says the balance is not calibrated, and you respond and say, well, we've now done it, here's the proof. FDA doesn't accept that anymore. They want to see, where did you investigate your system that allowed the balance to not be calibrated? That's the bigger systemic thing they want to see. So that's why they've changed that, because they realize they're coming once every 2-3 years, and they're only looking at 5%. Your trouble is you don't know which 5% they're going to look at. So you have to be 100% ready for a 5% inspection. Last slide, a few predictions. This is me and my crystal ball. I cannot predict this is going to happen. It's what I see happening. 1 minute over, I'm sorry. India and China will dominate the APIs and excipient supply and increasingly finished pharmaceutical product supply. The biggest area in India for pharmaceutical finished dosage forms is around Hyderabad, Andhra Pradesh, and in Europe they export 40% of all the generic drugs used in Europe from that one state. China is responsible for 80% of all API sales worldwide, and in the United States they are about 65% of all APIs come from China, about another 20% from India and the rest from everywhere else. So India and China are set to dominate. In the generic field, I'll give you a prediction and a warning. The day that America stops the embargo on Cuba, Cuba will become the center of the generic industry for the United States. Cuba today is the largest generic country of export for Africa and South America. And believe me, the day the embargo finishes, all those companies there meet World Health Organization GMPs. I've inspected every one of them, and they're all just dying for the embargo to drop. And of course, every American company will buy out those companies, a new source of generic drugs. Just be aware of that. It's a great country to visit, by the way. We're going to have unified GMP drug products worldwide. FDA never changed its GMPs when it joined PICS. I predict it will, because PICS is demanding it. And FDA has its clout to be able to say, for a few more years, we'll still have it our way. But they will join PICS. They're going to be harmonizing inspections. We already have lots of joint inspections. And as soon as we can be sure that all the inspectors who are members of PICS, which includes FDA, are inspecting and interpreting the same way, then we're going to end up with, we trust each other and we'll stop all the need for international travel. Inspection agencies in PICS are doing peer review. One country in PICS is about to lose its membership because its inspection agency went downhill as far as the quality of its inspections. I won't name the country because they're still fighting to retain their membership. But if that fails, and it'll be 6 months from now, we'll know, then they're going to be dropping from PICS. This is a real serious thing within PICS. If you're going to join PICS, you've got to keep to a certain standard of GMP inspection. And uniform reporting, and the FDA is going to start using the critical, major, minor categorization that PICS does. That's part of that membership commitment they made. We can see, and a lot of countries have told me this, that once we can harmonize API drug master files between countries, and we can harmonize inspection standards of APIs, then once that happens, and this is PICS again, you register in one PICS country, every other PICS country will be fine. So you don't have to re-register your API. Now, I will tell you that there's a problem with inspections of APIs. In Europe, they now want you to, if you sell an API into Europe, you have to give a certificate from your local country's authorities that they have inspected the factory and that they're happy from a GMP perspective. Europe thinks this is great because Europe doesn't have the manpower to go and inspect. Now, there's a big problem with that. In China, most companies are owned by the Communist Party. The inspectors come from the state, which is the Communist Party. Exports are vital for China. Which inspector is going to say, no, this company is garbage? It's not going to happen. So Europe's got a huge problem right now facing this. FDA was right. FDA was the first country to do international inspections of APIs in 1973. FDA was absolutely right on. And key excipients and their intermediaries are going to be considered as APIs. Sorry, key excipients and API intermediaries are going to be considered as APIs from a GMP inspection perspective. FDA, because there are no official GMPs for excipients, is still using API GMPs. People complain, so FDA uses the fallback and says, yeah, but this is nothing different than the USP guideline. So just be aware, excipient manufacturers out there are going to face a much, much tougher time. So, just lastly, a cultural dynamic for GMPs. China, I mentioned, give money, pass. Germany, they hate it. Great mountains of paper is still the attitude 30 years after GMPs. Japan, it means you're a playboy. You like golf, mahjong, and pachinko. When they call me, GMP-san, I thought it was flattering at first, and it's not anymore. Pachinko is the game where a little steel ball goes around and around and in a pocket, and then you win more steel balls. So people spend nights there. Singapore, I love this one. Gives maximum profit is their credo, what GMP stands for. Is there any pharmacist in the group here? Just me? Oh, sorry. All right, God made pharmacists. Okay, fine. If you have any questions, please, that's my email address. You'll never get me by phone. I'm always traveling. Thank you. And if there's any questions, that's it. Any questions?